Lord God, thank you for this man. Father, we pray that the words he speaks this morning will be your words speaking through his voice. And we ask this in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Okay. Thank you. Good morning, everyone. I'm so glad to be in your midst this morning. I'm so happy to be here. And David said, I was glad when they said, come, let us go to the house of the Lord. So each time it is time to be in the presence of God, I feel happy. Amen. I thank God who has made it possible for us all to be in his presence this morning, because the Bible says that in the presence of God, there is fullness of joy. And in his right hands, joy forevermore. Amen. I bring you all greetings from our ministry, Light of the City Ministries, which has just kicked off just a couple of weeks ago. Amen. They all send their love. Amen. This morning, I want to share with us from a very lively passage of the Bible, which talked about something that excites me very much, something that changed the entire course of my life. Something that moved me from point A to point where I am right now. Something that I believe that all of us as children of God need. Amen. My prayers goes to Reverend Martin, who's currently not in our midst. And I'm asking that God will keep him and his family. Amen. I will read from the book of Acts of Apostles, chapter 3, and what I'm going to speak to you this morning about, I have captioned it, such as I have, such as I have, which is taken from the book of Acts of Apostles, chapter number 3. It's a bit of a story, and I will read a bit fast, if you don't mind me. From verse 1 to 9, it says, now Peter and John went up together into the temple at the hour of prayer, being the ninth hour, and a certain man, lame from his mother's womb, was carried, whom they laid daily at the gate of the temple, which is called Beautiful, to ask alms of them that entered into the temple. Who, seeing Peter and John about to go into the temple, asked an alms. Verse 4, and Peter, fastening his eyes upon him with John, said, look on us. Look on us. And obviously the young man looked at them. Amen. And he gave heed unto them, expecting to receive something of them. He was looking to receive money of them. Then Peter said, silver and gold have I none, but such as I have, give I thee. Silver and gold have I none, but such as I have, give I thee. Then he issued a command which brought out what he has. Amen. Then he said, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, rise up and walk. Verse 7, and he took him by the right hand and lifted him up, and immediately his feet and ankle bones received strength. And he, leaping up, stood and walked and entered with them into the temple, walking and leaping and praising God. And all the people saw him walking and praising God. Hallelujah. Amen. I am so glad this morning that we all are here. I tell you something about this young man and the business with Peter. This isn't just about the miracle of healing. This is just not about the miracle of healing. It's about Peter setting this man's priority right. It's about Peter clearly indicating to him that, look, what you are asking me to give, I left behind many years. But there is something that you need, and you don't even know that you need. For many years, you have been carried to this gate, and you sat just here asking people for money. But two steps in, you could have actually been inside the church. Amen. And when you are in the church, things happen. When you are in the presence of God, anything can happen. Because you can't be in the presence of the King of Kings without something in your life changing. So Peter said to him, you remember a certain man who said to Jesus, good master, what is it that I may do to inherit the kingdom? And Jesus looked to him and said, well, you know the commandments of God. Keep all of them. And he said, I kept all of them. I keep all these commandments. And the Bible says that Jesus looked at him and loved him for keeping all the commandments of God. But Jesus turned back to him to say, but there is one thing that you lack. There is something that you lack so much. And that thing is for you to go and sell everything that you own. Bring the money, use it to feed the poor, then take the cross, then follow me. And the Bible says that this young man ran away sad. He ran, not looking back. Because why? The Bible said he had great possession. So some people hold on to these earthly things and hence missing out in the godly things. And here is this young man at the gate of beautiful saying to Peter, give me some kind of world value. And Peter said to him, the value that you ask him for, I left many years ago. Because when that young man ran away from the presence of Jesus Christ, Peter looked at Jesus and said to him, but we have left all and followed you. We've left all and we followed you. Then Jesus said something very important in that passage of the Bible. He says to Peter, listen, all of you. Say, anyone who have left father, left mother, brothers, sisters, left work, left anything for my sake and for the sake of the gospel, he said, now in this time will I give them 100 times fold of whatever you leave behind. Amen. Amen. So Peter said to this young man at the gate of beautiful that you're asking me for a value I left for the sake of this gospel. But I'll give you some values that you can find here in the world. What are the worldly values? Well, the world these days, they search for power. They can kill for power. They search for money. They can do anything for money. They search for entertainment. They can do anything just for them to get out there and have some fun. I'm not saying that these things in a moderate is not good. But when it becomes a God in your life, remember, Jesus said it would be difficult for a rich man to enter into the kingdom, especially if your money has become a God in your life. Amen. So this young man says to Peter, give me money. Peter said, well, I don't have money. I don't know about John. John, do you have something? John says, no. And he says, okay, since we don't have money, we're going to give you something. He says, in the name of Jesus Christ, whom we preach, rise up and walk. And at that command, the young man was still sitting until Peter extended a hand and pulled him up. And the Bible says, the bones and the ankles received strength. Beloved, I tell you something, there are some problems that will make you forget that you park a Rolls Royce right at the gate. There is a problem that will make you forget how much you have in your bank account. There is a problem that will make you forget the kind of house you're living in, because money don't buy life. Money don't buy happiness. Money don't buy joy. Money don't buy peace. The things we look for so much in this world, and we leave the things money cannot buy, searching for them. Truth is, when we go, we leave them behind. And this young man was down there, crippled for many years, couldn't get up. Then Peter said to him, rise and walk. He could have if he could, but he couldn't. Because sometimes in life, there are some kind of issues that will knock you down, and you can tell that on your own you can't be able to stand up again until somebody else will give you a hand. So do I have somebody in the house this morning who want to give somebody just one hand and say, I pull you out of your misery, I want to give you my hand for you to get to where you are going? Because you've been sitting for far too long. Some people are tied down in the hospital bed. Some people don't even know what tomorrow holds for them. But here is the thing. I've made peace with that already. Amen. It says, now in this time, I will give you both what you have left and what you have not asked for. Amen. So Peter carefully separated the values of this world from the values of God in this contest. And here is the thing. You know all about the golden rule? They said, they that have the gold, they make the rules. Isn't that what you were told? But so many people in search of gold missed God. Hallelujah. And with them and their gold, Jesus says, it will be easier for the camel to walk through the eye of a needle than for them to bring in their gold into this kingdom. So what do you have to do to get into that kingdom? Well, you seek God first, which is exactly what Matthew chapter 6, verse 33 says. It says, seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. And he said, every other thing shall be given to you. So it's not like you are losing at all. All that God is saying is, find me first, then I will give you what you need. I will give you what you need. Find me first. Set your priorities right. Look at what is happening in our entertainment industries today. A lot of people are selling their souls for the sake of fame. For how long? For how long? Between the ages of 20 to 30, they have reigned. But at 40, nobody wants to hear their voices anymore, because now age has caught up with them. And now they realize that they lost their soul for something that wasn't permanent in the first place. They lost their soul. And they struggle and they fight hard to come back, but they can't, because they are long gone. They don't even know the reality of life anymore. Now they need somebody to hold their hands to pull them out. They need a Peter who still have the values of God. They need you. They need me. They need somebody who can tell them the very essential of this life. Somebody who can say, look, I know what you've been through. I know that you make some certain wrong decisions, but here is the time, because it's never too late with God, because the very moment you turn back, his hands are widely open to embrace you. Come on, somebody say amen.
Amen.
That is the God that we serve. He doesn't judge you. Doesn't kill you because of what you've done wrong. All he's saying is, come back to me and I will come back to you. Amen. Here is the important thing here. This man, for many years, he was kept at that gate, but he never entered the temple. There was no record of him going into the temple. But from that day, his priorities were set right. And he received his healing. That day, he went into the temple. Somebody out there is waiting for you to put your holy hands on them and say, in the name of Jesus Christ, whom we preach, receive your strength, receive your joy, receive your peace, and come with me. Let's go into the hands of God, because in the presence of God, there is liberty, there is fullness of joy. You can find joy nowhere else but in the house of God. Somebody is waiting for you to pull them by their hands and pick them out of the mess that they are. I tell you something, God has loved me through the mess that I was. He's loved me through everything that I've been through. And today when I step into the church, I step with my shoulders high, because he delivered me out of the miry clay and set my feet upon the rock which is Jesus. I do not flutter anymore. I do not worry about tomorrow anymore, because God takes care of my needs. Amen. Even when he hasn't, the truth is, he will. The Bible says that he is not a tempter. That's why when we pray, we say, lead us not into temptation, but deliver us out of all troubles. So God can never lead you or allow you go through something that will lead you into temptation. Whatever he allows you to go through is something he is giving you grace to bear. The other day, I said to my wife, you know, whatever God don't give you now is detrimental to you. Because throughout the whole Bible, throughout the whole scripture, he says, I'll give you the desires of your heart. I know the thoughts that I have about you. They are thoughts of good, not evil, of evil. I wish above all things that you prosper, be in good health, even as your soul prospereth. So if all these promises is in the scripture, why is it that God hasn't given you something that you've so much asked for? It's because that thing is detrimental to you. The very moment he gives you that thing, you are not matured enough to handle it yet. You have not received the strength and the power to handle it yet. So that thing will lead you astray, lead you away from God. And that's why he is waiting. And he's saying, in your time of waiting, learn, become strong. Because even youth will faint, young men be exhausted, but they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. So when you wait upon the Lord, your strengths are renewed. You never can tell how strong you have become until you see yourself standing alone with God. You never can tell how much strong and strength you carry until people have stopped carrying you. You can never tell what you can be able to do if people are doing so much for you. So here is the thing. We are all called into the ministry of reconciliation and love. My prayer today for somebody here is that we pick the values of Jesus and leave the earthly values. It is your portion and your birthright to reign on earth and reign in heaven. But first you have to find God if you have to claim such promises. So like that young man who never heard to set his priority right, we will make a different choice this morning. And that choice is for us to set our priorities right. The values of God says what? I give you a few of them. Just like the values of this world is wealth, power, pleasure, revenge, fame, status. What are the values of God? The values of God says kindness and respect for all people instead of power. It says humility instead of status. It says honesty and generosity instead of wealth accumulation. It says self-control instead of self-indulgence. It says forgiveness instead of revenge. Godly values brings you to the place of healing. If that young man's heart wasn't changed that day, he obviously wouldn't have received his healing. God has brought me here today for somebody. Somebody who needs to set their priorities right. In my home, it has started. My kids know the place of God. Whatsoever, my young one, my last born 3 years old, when he gets some stomach bug, he says to me, Daddy, my stomach hurts. I say, you know what to do. And he goes to the corner, he places his hands in the stomach, and he said, be healed in the name of Jesus. That's him over there. And many times he has prayed for me, and I see pain go away. And I have seen him pray in the hospital for a doctor, 3 years old. I was amazed. He made tears come out of my eyes because the older brother was in the hospital we went to for some checkup. So they've injected him. He was crying. So he goes there, lays his hand on his head, and he started praying. The doctor asked me, what is he doing? I said, he's praying for his brother. The doctor said, are you serious? I said, yes. And the doctor knelt down and said, pray for me. And he placed his hand upon his head and started praying for him. The doctor went out, bring all the nurses in the hospital, and asked them to come in. These are the values I'm talking about. I tell you, when you give this to your children, you'll be amazed what they will do. You will be amazed what they will achieve. You will be amazed how life will change totally for your good. Because remember, Romans chapter 8 says, all things work together for good for them that love God and called according to his purpose. Why not start now planting these values in your life, in your children's life? You know, we sometimes say, why is it that our young ones don't want to come to church anymore? Because we've stopped talking to them about God. Because somehow we ourselves have given up. How can they pick something that they don't see in us? I'll tell you something, if I buy a new dog today, that dog wouldn't have a name until I give it one. And once I give my dog a name, few months to come, if I call that name, the dog will come running. That's what our lives are like. As unstable as water may be, you can actually channel water into a place. If you make a channel, water will follow it. The current of water could be very disastrous, unstable, but if you create a channel for the water will follow. What am I trying to say? Things we are complaining, things are difficult, but we can actually set these things right. We can make it happen if we choose to set our priorities right. So I want to see if there is somebody in the house this morning who's saying, but I need to get out of some things for me first before I take this home. It's okay. God is the healer. He is the miracle worker. And before he exited the earth in the human form, he said to his disciples, hallelujah, so that it wouldn't be my word, I'm going to read it from the scripture. Mark chapter 16, verse 16. Verse 17. And these signs shall follow them that believe. In my name, they shall cast out demons. They shall speak with new tongues. They shall take up serpents. And if they drink any deadly thing, it shall not hurt them. They shall lay hands on the sick, and they shall recover. If you think about these words, these few little words that came from two verses, you will see that it deals with everything that you go through in life. Everything that could be a challenge in our lives are sorted in two verses of the scripture. Everything, sickness, poison, wrong decisions, addictions, everything sorted into scriptures. And this was at the very day of ascension. Jesus was going to stay with the Father in heaven, and he said to us, I have given you the power to do these things, all of these. Amen. I don't know how Christchurch Bushmead does this, but this is the time where I ask people to please either bow down in your head, bow down your head, or stand up on your feet if you wish like, and we hold our hands together and we say, God, let thy kingdom come in our lives. Please, I will sincerely urge everybody to stand up on your feet. Hold your neighbor's hands. Hold your neighbor's hands. The Church of Christ, Jesus says, my Father's house shall be called the house of prayer, where sicknesses are healed. The presence of the Holy Spirit is already here. Nothing shall be difficult at this moment. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, whom we preach every day, whom we preach every now and then, Lord, I ask that the Holy Spirit will carry out his assignment in our midst this morning. I command every sickness in the name of Jesus to get out. I command every form of addiction to get out in the name of Jesus. I command every promiscuous addiction to get out in the name of Jesus. I command healing to come upon every soul. I command healing upon every spirit. I command healing upon every body. Oh, the Bible says that if this spirit that raised Jesus Christ from the dead is in you, the same spirit shall quicken your mortal body. I command your bodies to begin to quicken up now in the name of Jesus. Your soul shall be restored. Your joy shall be restored. Your spirit is restored. From this moment, nothing shall stop you again. The words that we speak to you, the Bible declares that they are spirit and they are life. And in the book of John chapter 1, the Bible says, and this word was made flesh and it came to dwell among us. This word bring light upon your soul, that darkness will disappear. The light that darkness cannot comprehend, that light is Jesus. Let this light overshadow you. Let this light come upon you in the name of Jesus Christ. I speak deliverance into every dark situation. Every unshed tears I wipe in the name of Jesus. Amen. Any form of loneliness, I condemn in the name of Jesus. And I proclaim over your life and over your family the acceptable year of liberty of God in the name of Jesus. Your soul is liberated in the name of Jesus. No longer shall you be heavy again in the name of Jesus. The strength of God, the grace of God has come upon you, and from this moment you shall begin to do things you couldn't have done in before. Thank you, everlasting Father. We bless your holy name. It's all about you, Jesus. We give you back all the glory. We give you back all adoration. We exalt you for the wonderful things you've done this morning, for this awesome experience, for the things that you have brought back and restored us to. Thank you, Jesus. In Jesus' most precious name we pray. Amen. And thank you for holding anybody's, your neighbor's hands. Thank you for praying for them. Please shake somebody's hands and say, thank you for praying with me. Hallelujah. Amen. God has blessed you this morning. God bless you. Thank you very much, and God bless you. Amen.